Good morning, PHS. Today is February 2nd, 2017. I'm Devin Gritton, and with me today, once again, another guest anchor. Today, we have Bridget Schaefer. Thank you for being here today, Bridget.
Thanks, Devin. I'm honored to be here. Well, PHS, we have a lot to get on to, so let's get this show on the road.
We're going to get you started off with the SRT meetings and after school meetings. During SRT, the Sunshine Club will be meeting in room 203, Prayer Club will be meeting in 207, and there is a girls track call out meeting in 212. After school, the Winter Winds group is meeting in the music wing, and robotics, you guys are meeting in room 141 starting at 3:30.
This Saturday, Plymouth High School will be hosting the school's second VEX Robotics Tournament. PHS Robotics Club would like to invite you to come out and witness the 2017 VEX Robotics Game VRC Star Trek. Last year, 24 teams competed in the tournament. This year, 46 teams have already signed up. Admission to the PHS Robotics Tournament, which will be held in the varsity gym, is free. The first qualifying matches will begin around 9:30 a.m., and the championship rounds will start close to 3 p.m. And the awards ceremony is slated to occur between 4:30 p.m. and 5 p.m. Concessions will be available. The team which receives the Excellence Award automatically qualifies for the state championship. And the team which is crowned the Robot Skills winner automatically qualifies for the National Robotics Championship. And the tournament champions qualify both state and nationals. Now, the PHS debate team finished 8th in the IHSFA state tournament last Friday and Saturday at Kokomo High School. Senior Garrett Garver won a state championship in congressional debate. Garrett debated over 60 other students on 9 pieces of legislation through 3 preliminary chambers, 3 semifinal chambers, and 3 final chambers, and dominated the tournament. Sophomore Trent McKenzie also earned a state championship as a presiding officer, ultimately presiding over the Super Senate. He presided over all 3 levels of competition, along with other presiding officer candidates. 3 PHS students advanced to the semifinal level of competition, earning points for the team as well. Those students included freshman Kelsey Cryer, as well as sophomores Nicole Keller and Jack Garner. PHS was also represented by its first World Schools debate team that included Bridget Schaefer, Samantha Ezekiel, Trevor Pletcher, Olivia Clark, and Parker Gamble. The Junior Prom Committee will be holding a fundraiser at the Plymouth Pizza Hut on Monday, February 6th from 5 to 8 p.m. A portion of the proceeds from the salad bar will be donated to this year's prom fund. Some students from the junior class will also be working to serving drinks for tips.
Back for the second week in a row, the segment called Simple Things You Should Know will certainly make you think.
The photographer Juan Garcia and reporter Devin Gritton put together the second installment. Let's check it out.
Tentative?
A teapot.
A teapot, okay.
Which type of house weighs the least?
A lighthouse. Okay, that's it. Teddy bears are never hungry, but they are always what?
Fuzzy.
No, stuffed.
Oh! Okay.
Okay, my God. What can travel around the world?
Okay. A boat and a glass bottle.
No, a stamp.
Thanks, Juan, for putting that segment together for us.
All right, guys, when we come back, we're talking about PTV sports. Stay with us for trivia and a Super Bowl contest with some money on the line if you want to win.
Hi, everybody. This is Allison Hayes from the Big Ten Network and ABC 57 Saturday Kickoff. You're watching PTV Sports.
Hey.
All right, folks, it's time to tell you what's on the schedule for our PHS sports events tonight. Boys basketball is facing off against Goshen here at home at 6:15 p.m. Girls basketball team also has their sectional at LaPorte at 6 p.m. And the girls swim team has their sectional at Warsaw beginning at 5:30.
Congratulations to our Rocky wrestlers who won a huge come-from-behind championship last weekend. PHS had 10 regional qualifiers, 6 sectional champions, 2 second-place finishers, and 2 fourth-place finishers. Plymouth was down by 25 points to CMA with 6 matches to go and mounted a miracle comeback. Caleb Koss upset the number 1 seed from CMA in the finals to keep our hopes alive, and then it came down to the final match of the day. Sam Staten won the finals to secure the Rocky victory. Placing for Plymouth were the following students: Graham Calhoun, first; Gavin Banks, first; Mike Calhoun, first; Colton Schuler, first; Caleb Koss, first; Sam Staten, first; Nate LaFree, second; Zane DeVault, second; Blake Davis, fourth; Graham Chapman, fourth; Arturo Valdez, sixth.
PHS this weekend, for those who live under a rock, it's Super Bowl Sunday! We asked some of you who think would win and what you thought the winning score would be.
And there's a prize on the line for the top 2 winners who come the closest with the end score to the game and pick the course of the winning team. The first place winner will receive a $25 Wings Etc. gift card, and the second place winner receives a $10 gift card to Wings. Good luck, everybody. We'll announce the first and second place winner on the next show.
What is your prediction on the Super Bowl?
I think the Patriots are going to win 28-21.
The Patriots, probably.
What do you think the score is going to be?
Maybe like 32-17.
All right, Clay, who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl, the Patriots or the Falcons?
Falcons, 27-24.
All right, thank you. All right, Edward, who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl, the Patriots and the Falcons?
The Patriots.
What do you think the score will be?
21-10.
Who do you think will win the Super Bowl, the Patriots or the Falcons?
Well, I think it's definitely, even though I hate them, it's got to be the Patriots. And I would say it's the Patriots, 42, the Falcons, 3.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Messer.
Who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl?
Falcons, because Patriots suck. And I'm probably going to go like 34-28.
Falcons are going to win the Super Bowl. 43-39.
I've got the Atlanta Falcons winning 42-10.
Super Bowl, I'm going with the Pats, and I'm saying it's going to be 30-17.
Falcons, homie, 38-12.
For the Super Bowl, I think the Pats are going to win 41-7, so that's my prediction.
I got Atlanta Falcons over the Patriots, 62-56.
Yeah, I got Patriots 46-30.
Good. Atlanta's going to win, but I'm going to say Atlanta's going to win 35-21.
My guess for the score against the Patriots and the Falcons is probably 20 to maybe 10.
I think the score will be 31-27, and the Falcons will win.
31-27 Falcons.
I believe the Falcons will win. 24-17.
I say the Patriots are going to win 26-32.
I believe the Falcons will win 35-31.
I think that the Patriots are going to win the Super Bowl, and the score is going to be 24-21.
I think the Falcons will win 50-22.
I think the Patriots are going to win 27-24.
My prediction is the Super Bowl score will be 31-27, and Tom Brady and the Patriots will win.
Patriots are going to win, and the score is going to be 40-30.
I think the Patriots are going to win 31-10.
It's almost that time of the show, PTV trivia time. But before then, let's recap the previous week's question. So you know the answer, and you find out who the winning class was too. This video was taken by PTV photojournalist Juan Garcia. He captured Ms. McCullough's room as they cashed in on their delicious prize for winning last week's trivia question. The question, by the way, was, what two soccer teams play in El Clásico? The answer is Barcelona and Real Madrid.
It's that time of the week again, trivia time. This week, our question will be, what team has won the most Super Bowls? Call extension 1241 now if you know the answer. Again, the question is, what team has won the most Super Bowls? Again, if you know the answer, try to win our delicious prize and call extension 1241 right now. It's an all-new month, so every classroom can play.
Now taking a look at what is for lunch today. We'll be having chicken and noodles, mashed potatoes, fruit and vegetable bar, and dinner rolls.
Well, that's all we have for you guys today. Thank you, Bridget, for joining us today. We, as a PTV crew, appreciate it from the bottom of our hearts.
Aw, you're welcome, Devin. Thank you guys for having me.
Remember, PHS, every day we have a podcast with news you might have missed during the week. Tune in every Thursday for the show. Until next time, have a great rest of the day, PHS, and go Pilgrims!